Let us look at this research abstract written by doctors in relation to coughing. Study: the role of cough and hyperventilation in perpetuating airway inflammation in asthma, published in Journal of Association of Physicians of India, 2000, Department of Pulmonary Medicine, SMS Medical College, Jaipur, India. Air flowing through a pipe exerts frictional stress on the walls of the pipe. Frictional stress of more than 40 newtons per square meter, velocity equivalent of air 130 meters per second, is known to cause acute endothelial damage in blood vessels. The frictional stress in airways during coughing may be much greater, however, since the velocity of air may be as high as speed of sound in air. We suggest that high levels of frictional stress perpetuate airway inflammation in airways, which are already inflamed and vulnerable to frictional stress-induced trauma in patients with asthma. Activities associated with rapid ventilation and higher frictional stress, e.g. exercise, hyperventilation, coughing, sneezing, and laughing, cause asthma to worsen. Therefore, control of cough may have anti-inflammatory benefits in patients with asthma. What happens during coughing? We lose too much CO2, and carbon dioxide is very important for healing of our airways, for normal work of our urge to cough receptors, because when we hyperventilate, and this is exactly the case according to many medical studies with for people with COPD, asthma, cystic fibrosis, and other conditions, these people have reduced amount of CO2 in the airways, and that causes irritation of the urge to cough receptors. And therefore we have chronic problems with coughing. Apart from that, heavy breathing or hyperventilation reduces oxygen level in body cells. And that causes suppression of the immune system, because when we develop cell hypoxia or tissue hypoxia, we start to generate free radicals in cells due to anaerobic respiration of our cells. So oxygen is very fundamental for our health, and hyperventilation causes exactly the opposite effect. Therefore, people with chronic coughing are going to benefit from very simple breathing exercises, which are going to be explained next. The very first step is to learn how to cough only through your nose. So you keep your mouth closed and start coughing only through the nose. The next step is to learn how to cough with your mouth and with your nose closed. That means you close your nose and try coughing this way. This way you are going to have about normal concentration of CO2 in your airways, and that going to calm down your urge to cough receptors. In addition, there is a third exercise, which is called the reduced breathing exercise, and this reduced breathing exercise will teach you how to breathe a little bit less air, so that you have more carbon dioxide, more CO2, which improve oxygen transport. When you anticipate cough or have a coughing attack, bout of coughing, find a comfortable place where you can sit with a straight spine and relax. Close your mouth, pinch your nose, and start breath holding until you get a desire to breathe more, air hunger or shortage of air. When you release your nose, it is very important that you take your first inhalation through the nose and using the diaphragm or your abdominal muscles. But you need to make this inhalation smaller or shorter than you want or than you had before this exercise. Therefore, after the breath hold, make a small nasal abdominal inhalation, as it is shown on this diagram. After this inhalation, you need to relax all your body muscles in order to exhale. Remember, just relax all your muscles for exhalations. Then again, you take a small nasal abdominal inhalation and relax to exhale, as it is shown on the diagram. Your goal is to maintain or preserve moderate air hunger or desire to breathe more air during this exercise. In other words, you need to gently but persistently self-suffocate yourself with little breathing. This reduced breathing results in higher CO2 levels in airways and increased oxygen levels in body cells. Structure of the exercise: 1 breath holding, 2 reduced breathing with air hunger, and total relaxation of all body muscles. In average, about 2-3 minutes are enough to stop or alleviate coughing attacks. Warning: if you suffer from hypertension, migraines, or panic attacks, avoid breath holding and accumulate air hunger very gradually. A similar exercise with its own details is very effective to stop coughing at night during sleep and fall asleep faster. And eventually, when you achieve about 30 seconds for the body oxygen test, you are going to eliminate inflammation in significant degree and your bouts of coughing will disappear completely.